Hello, my dear subscribers and channel viewers. One of the channel viewers wrote in, "Hello, my dear subscribers and channel viewers." One of the channel viewers wrote in the comments that I am an alien. Very maybe. So, today we will talk about the engine in a UFO. Everyone knows about aliens and flying saucers, and everyone's attitude to this object is different. Most of humanity, which believes in aliens, is sure that the aliens are ahead of us in development. But how much? Let's think about it. What engines are installed in flying saucers? Maybe not so far behind the technology of extraterrestrials. What do we know about UFOs? Not as much as I would like. We don't know their targets, where they came from, or what the pilots are. We can't even 100% say, are their ships manned? All we have are eyewitness accounts and video footage. As we know, UFOs can hover in the air, and the speed of their aircraft is so high that they can travel tens of kilometers per second. Let's stop at the speed. Researchers from the University of Edinburgh managed to calculate the estimated speeds of the flying saucers. It is about 30,000 km per hour, or 8.3 km per second. This is just above the first space speed. We have long been subdued by such speeds. Another thing is that Earth missiles that achieve such indicators are huge and consist mainly of fuel. And this is not observed in flying saucers. But our aircrafts can't levitate. So the alien aircrafts don't run on liquid fuel like our rockets. But we do have some ideas. The cost of launching satellites and spaceships makes us look of other solutions. And in theory, there are two prototype engines. The first is a nuclear powered engine, and the second is antimatter powered. If the second type exists only on paper, then the first engine has already been created. The RD-0410 engine was designed and built in the USSR in the period from 1965 to 1985. Its mass was only 2 tons, and the specific impulse was 900 seconds, which is 3 times higher than the pH of the proton. Hypothetically, the alien ships may contain a similar installation. An antimatter engine is a great prospect for space travel. But we have problems with this. How to get enough antimatter? And most importantly, how to preserve it? What else can be installed in alien ships? There is an opinion, about anti-gravity and magnetic motors. Such assumptions arose because of the peculiarity of UFOs to hover in the air. The development of magnetic motors has been undertaken by eminent scientists, but significant progress has not been achieved. It's unlikely that they are installed in alien ships. Magnets do not carry any energy. Even if we assume that the UFO levitates in the sky due to the Earth's magnetic field and magnetic motor, it will be impossible in outer space. And not all celestial bodies have a magnetic field. The anti-gravity engine is still undeveloped technology. Even if we assume that the aliens have an installation of this type, it should work in conjunction with another motor that provides movement on Earth at a speed of up to 30,000 km per hour. The anti-gravity drive would only allow the aliens to take off and land. To sum up, the most obvious candidate for the role of a UFO engine is an engine powered by nuclear energy or antimatter. Many will object that UFO have installation that creates wormholes. Perhaps, but such technology are required for traveling in outer space. Now the analysis was how they move on the Earth. It is impossible to say that we are hopelessly behind the alien civilization. Most likely, the most technologically advanced aliens appears earlier than humanity, and now we are no more than thousands of years apart. I can give you an example. Shipbuilding. A thousand years ago, ships were propelled by oars, but now by engines. If you compare us and the aliens, we are still moving in space on oars, but it is only a matter of time. But also I have one more position, and this position is about ancient Vimana, which were built in India.